This is Special Prosecutor Larry Klayman.
I'm the only lawyer ever to obtain a court ruling that a president of the United States committed a crime.
For truth. For competition.
As a young lawyer, I helped break up AT&T. That's why you have all your cell phones today.
For sovereignty. For the Republic.
I'm the guy who at Judicial Watch, which I founded, uncovered the Chinagate scandal. Millions of dollars going to the Clinton campaign, corrupting our political system.
For the privacy of citizens.
And I'm the only guy to have enjoined the National Security Agency from mass surveillance on hundreds of millions of Americans.
Tearing it up.
I'm the son of meatpackers in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I know how to slice and dice.
Bringing it back.
We're going to take this country apart and put it back together again in the way envisioned by our founding fathers.
It's not just talk.
We're not just regurgitating news stories. Larry Klayman, special prosecutor, is making the news.
And now, here's Larry.
Welcome to this edition of Special Prosecutor with Larry Klayman. I hope that you all had a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We're back. We're working. We're rolling up our sleeves. We at Freedom Watch and in my private practice are attempting to bring about justice. And just this week, we can see the injustice. In the melee that followed all of the events with regard to Iran, with regard to the attack on Soleimani that killed him, which was a very good idea, the head of the Quds force of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard, the Democrat pushback on that, the manipulated politics that occurred thereafter, the Iranian response in bombing our air bases in Iraq, and of course the shootdown of the Ukrainian airliner by Iran. I don't think that was accidental, but I don't need to get into that here. There was some news that leaked out, and it was done intentionally during this period so no one would see. And the news was, it came through the Washington Post and undoubtedly was leaked by the lawyers of the Clintons, Williams and Connolly, which not coincidentally represents the Washington Post, that Hillary Clinton would not be held to account. She would not be indicted for the misuse of the Clinton Foundation, a shakedown of various entities that pumped money into the Clinton Foundation, which obviously wound up in the Clintons' pockets while she was Secretary of State. Now, this investigation had been assigned by former Attorney General Jeffrey Beauregard Sessions to a guy named John Huber, a U.S. attorney in Utah. And at the time, great things were promised. They were promised not just by the Justice Department, but they were promised by people like Sean Hannity on Fox News. There's always going to be justice around the corner here. That's the way you boost ratings, you boost advertising dollars. But sure enough, this week it was leaked by Williams and Connolly, obviously from government prosecutors at my former alma mater, the Justice Department, that no action would be taken. Now, who's Attorney General now? Attorney General Bill Barr, the so-called legal messiah that was put in as Attorney General, that is pumped up every single night on Hannity and on Fox News as now justice is around the corner. The same legal messiah who my former group, Judicial Watch, says, okay, now I've got documents, now please, Justice Department, take action. Well, you know what? I don't look to Bill Barr or the Justice Department to take action. I do it myself at Freedom Watch, like I used to do after I founded and ran Judicial Watch for 10 years. And in addition to that, this week it was reported that Chelsea Clinton had taken $8 million from a corporation to sit on its corporate board. And my God, how does she get it? $9 million, actually. That's like Hunter Biden, all the money he got, you know, sitting on corporate boards. And now he has a house in the Hollywood Hills that he rents for $10,000 a month at the same time that he's bankrupt. And he's got tax liens and fathered a child in paternity. There was a ruling this week. I mean, the world's upside down. But I'll tell you something. Ricky Gervais, a Hollywood comedian, a Brit, gave a monologue at the Golden Globes this week, which ripped Hollywood to shreds. And I want you to hear it, because the same criticism that applies to Hollywood applies to the ugly people of Washington, D.C., the elite. They always say Washington is Hollywood for ugly people. And I want you to listen to this right now, and then we're going to talk about it in the second segment.
Welcome to the 77th Annual Golden Globe Awards, live from the Beverly Hilton Hotel here in Los Angeles. I'm Ricky Gervais. Thank you. You'll be pleased to know this is the last time I'm hosting these awards, so I don't care anymore. I'm joking. I never did. NBC clearly don't care either. fifth time. So, I mean, Kevin Hart was fired from the Oscars because of some offensive tweets.
Hello.
Lucky for me, the Hollywood Foreign Press can barely speak English. And they've no idea what Twitter is. So I got offered this gig by fax. So let's go out with a bang. Let's have a laugh at your expense, shall we? Remember, they're just jokes. We're all going to die soon, and there's no sequel. So, yeah, remember that. But you all look lovely, all dolled up. You came here in your limos. I came here in a limo tonight, and the license plate was made by Felicity Huffman. So, no. Shush. It's her daughter I feel sorry for, OK? That must be the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to her. And her dad was in Wild Hogs. So, lots of big celebrities here tonight. I mean, legends, icons, yeah? Look, at this table alone, Al Pacino, Robert De Niro. Baby Yoda. Oh, that's Joe Pesci, sorry. I love you, man. Don't have me whacked. But tonight isn't just about the people in front of the camera. In this room are some of the most important TV and film executives in the world. People from every background, but they all have one thing in common. They're all terrified of Ronan Farrow. He's coming for you. He's coming for you. Look, talking of all you perverts, it was a big year... It was a big year for paedophile movies. Surviving R. Kelly, Leaving Neverland, Two Popes. Shut up. Shut up. I don't care. I don't care. Many talented people of colour were snubbed in major categories. Unfortunately, there's nothing we can do about that. The Hollywood Foreign Press are all very, very racist. So, fifth time. So... We were going to do an in memoriam this year, but when I saw the list of people that had died, it wasn't diverse enough. It just... No. It was mostly white people. And I thought, nah, not on my watch. So, maybe next year. Let's see what happens. No one cares about movies anymore. No one goes to the cinema. No one really watches network TV. Everyone's watching Netflix. This show should just be me coming out going, well done, Netflix, you win everything. Good night. But no, no, we've got to drag it out for 3 hours. You could binge watch the entire first season of Afterlife instead of watching this show. That's a show about a man who wants to kill himself because his wife dies of cancer. And it's still more fun than this, okay? Spoiler alert, season 2 is on the way, so in the end, he obviously didn't kill himself. Just like Jeffrey Epstein. Shut up! I know he's your friend, but I don't care. You had to make your own way here in your own plane, didn't you? Right, but seriously, most films are awful, lazy, remakes, sequels. I've heard a rumour that there might be a sequel to Sophie's Choice. I mean... That'd just be Meryl Streep going, well, it's got to be this one, then. All the best actors have jumped to Netflix and HBO, you know. And the actors who just do Hollywood movies now do fantasy adventure nonsense. They wear masks and capes and really tight costumes. Their job isn't acting anymore. It's going to the gym twice a day and taking steroids, really. Have we got an award for most ripped junkie? No. No point. We know he'd win that. Martin Scorsese, the greatest living director, made the news for his controversial comments about the Marvel franchise. He said they're not real cinema and they remind him of theme parks. I agree. Although I don't know what he's doing hanging around theme parks. He's not big enough to go on the rides, is he? It's tiny. Right. The Irishman... was amazing. It was amazing. Look, it was. It was great. Long, but amazing. It wasn't the only epic movie. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, nearly 3 hours long, Leonardo DiCaprio attended the premiere, and by the end, his date was too old for him. So, even Prince Andrew's like, come on, Leo, mate, you know. You're nearly 50, son. The world got to see James Corden as a fat pussy. He was also in the movie Cats, but no one saw that. And the reviews, oh, shocking. I saw one that said, this is the worst thing to happen to cats since dogs, right? But Dame Judi Dench defended the film, saying it was the role she was born to play. Because she... I can't do this next joke. Because she loves nothing better than plonking herself down on the carpet, lifting her leg and licking her... verbal. She's old school. It's the last time, who cares? Oh. Apple roared into the TV game with a morning show. A superb drama, yeah. A superb drama about the importance of dignity and doing the right thing, made by a company that runs sweatshops in China. So, well, you say you're woke, but the companies you work for, I mean, unbelievable. Apple, Amazon, Disney. If ISIS started a streaming service, you'd call your agent, wouldn't you? So, if you do win an award tonight, don't use it as a platform to make a political speech, right? You're in no position to lecture the public about anything. You know nothing about the real world. Most of you spent less time in school than Greta Thunberg. So, if you win, right, come up, accept your little award, thank your agent and your God, and so... It's already 3 hours long.
We right back with comment on the monologue by Ricky Gervais.
Dangerous.
I don't care. Use the court and the law.
Lethal.
This is bad.
Special prosecutor.
Very bad.
Larry Klayman.
If you'd like to support Freedom Watch and this radio show, go to freedomwatchusa.org.
I wanted to play this monologue of Ricky Gervais at the Golden Globe Awards because it applies not just to Hollywood, but it applies to Washington, D.C., and unfortunately, large segments of the country as a whole. There are so many people out there that don't know what they're talking about. There's so much hypocrisy. There's so much lying. There's so much cheating. And Ricky Gervais, who's a liberal, believe it or not, stuck it up the derriere of the Hollywood elite. And at the end, as you heard, he said, look, you should come up and get your reward, accept it, and then sit down because you don't know anything about the way the world and this country works. Well, that's the purpose of this radio show, is to educate people as to the way things really work. And people think sometimes, you know, Larry Klayman is pessimistic. I'm not pessimistic. I'm optimistic. But I have to tell the truth. Unlike what you hear with Sean Hannity and Fox News, I'm not going to tell you pie-in-the-sky rosy predictions to get you to eat more popcorn and drink more beer sitting on your couch. It's time to get up off that couch. I want you to be educated like the colonialists were in the years leading up to 1776 that caused us to fight a revolution, to form a new nation, to form a republic, to form a free and great people living under liberty. Well, we don't have that liberty anymore. We don't. We have the NSA who does mass surveillance that keeps us down, Orwellian. We have no law enforcement establishment that will hold the beautiful people, which are the flip side of the Hollywood beautiful people, accountable to the rule of law. You heard Gervais say, you're all friends with Jeffrey Epstein. That's right. They were. And they're scared of Ronan Farrow, who's going to expose more sexual perversion in Hollywood. And, you know, he went on and on and on. That's why they say that Washington is Hollywood for ugly people. I mean, and they gravitate to each other. You can see at these events, you find a lot of politicians, you find a lot of Hollywood people at events in D.C., and a lot of politicians at events in L.A. They're part of the same superficial clown show that is destroying this country. And that is why I do what I do at Freedom Watch and in my private practice. It's why, as I said in our monologue, there's no justice with regard to the Clintons or any elite establishment, so-called nobility in Washington, D.C. There's no justice in Hollywood either. No, there's not. They just make more money when they do things that are incorrect. Look at Ricky Gervais. He's saying, I won't be invited back again. I don't care. You know what? Ricky Gervais will be invited back again because he's a very clever comedian and he boosts ratings. And it doesn't matter what he says to them. They're whores. They, as he said, would take money, would do a streaming service with ISIS if it could make them money. And that's the way people are in Washington, D.C. So I wanted you to hear that. And it's important that you hear that. Because we are now up against a lot of very powerful forces in this country. And I'm going to bring them to justice through our citizens' grand juries. Go to freedomwatchusa.org, whether it's Robert Mueller, or whether it's the Clintons, or whether it's the Obamas, or James Clappers, or John Brennan's, or whoever. Rod Rosenstein this week, you know, he walked off into the sunset and got a job with King & Spalding, a large Atlanta-based law firm, for, I'm sure, hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions of dollars. You know, Hillary Clinton has made millions. So has Bill Clinton. Hunter Biden, look at him. Look at how he raked in money illegally from Ukrainian interests. Now he's living in high and mighty in the Hollywood Hills at the same time that he's got tax liens against him. You know, it's unbelievable. So this is why we have to bring about justice. And from every part of society, whether it's our law enforcement establishment in the deep state, whether it's the clowns on Capitol Hill, or the corrupt clowns, whether it's the politicized hack federal judges who basically paper over and are yes men of the establishment elite, whether it's the fake left-wing media, or whether it's some bar associations in very liberal states like New York who now are going after the president, going after Bill Barr. I mean, why bother going after Bill Barr? He doesn't do anything anyway. He's put his head in the sand. Look at what happened just this week with regard to Hillary Clinton's. So we need to do it for ourselves, and we need to rise up, we the American people. So join Freedom Watch's Justice League. Go to freedomwatchusa.org. Contribute to our cause. Contribute to the Clive and Bundy Defense Fund.org. Contribute to the Corsi Legal Defense Fund.com. We need the resources to rise up for the American people, and we need your support and financial. And we need your prayers, because we will succeed. God has his hand on our shoulder, and I am convinced that with perseverance, fearless perseverance, that we will return this city and this country to that shining city on a hill that is talked about in Isaiah of the Bible. I'll be right back with Ben Stein, my great friend, who's going to comment on what went on in Hollywood this week.
Now, four words that make corrupt politicians make wee-wee in their little pants.
Transparency and the rule of law will be the touchstones of this president.
But we have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it.
Special Prosecutor Larry Klayman.
Be the one who makes our country great again. Go to freedomwatchusa.org and donate.
I'm back with my good friend, Yale lawyer. Excellent lawyer, excellent actor, comedian, writer, Ben Stein, my very good friend. And I wanted to ask Ben, we played earlier the monologue of Ricky Gervais at the Golden Globes just this week, where he criticized Hollywood, the hypocrisy, told them basically that they had no business telling the rest of the country what to think in political matters in particular, because they had no real world experience, and ripped them apart in many other respects. I wanted to get Ben's take on it because he's lived out here for a very, very long time. He's dealt with it. He's been successful. He's had to deal with the Hollywood left in particular and did it with great success. But still, he suffers from what goes on out here, and we all do. So, Ben, I want to turn it over to you and give you your thoughts on Hollywood glitter-eye elite giving the country their opinion on what they think, not just about Donald Trump, but basically everything under the sun.
Well, they think that they know more than the rest of us because they have bigger paychecks than the rest of us, and because they are more glamorous than the rest of us, nicer cars than the rest of us, and nicer houses than the rest of us. but they don't really know anything more than the rest of us do. And in fact, as a person who has spent a lot of time with the glitterati, as you call them, they know very little, and they have fantasy ideas about the world. I mean, it's interesting. We used to live in Aspen. My wife and I used to live in Aspen, and we just our mouths were hanging open, like just a gape at how little these people in Hollywood knew about what was going on in the real world. I mean, because people in America are so stupid, they wouldn't know how to use technological warfare in order to run from them, how to use it. And when we would hear things like that, we want to go home and hide ourselves.
Do you think that Ricky Gervais is going to be blackballed by Hollywood after this monologue?
No. Hollywood doesn't blackball people unless they don't bring in any money. I mean, you know, it's an interesting thing. The sound of Hollywood is the sound of money. And if his show did well ratings-wise, it doesn't matter what he says. He can say F you to Hollywood. As long as it's bringing in money, it doesn't matter.
Well, actually, he did use the F word, as a matter of fact. He told them to get up on the stage, get their award, thank their God. Of course, Ricky Gervais doesn't believe in God, so he said that sarcastically. And then he said, get the F off the stage at that point. So he actually did use the F word in that context. He ripped into every aspect of Hollywood. I urge people to listen to this monologue. Of course, we've played it in our show in the opening segment, but digested very well, because over the years, I spent a lot of time out here in addition to D.C. and Florida, my home state, and I know what it's up against. I know what conservatives are up against. I almost sold the show years ago until a producer at Warner Brothers decided she didn't like my politics. And that's what, you know, we're up against continuously. And that's why, you know, in groups like Friends of Abe that used to exist, it was underground.
Larry, I've had that happen all the time. I had a show which I sold to ABC about an America which was dying to be ripped apart by a political civil war. And they, at the last minute, they said, oh, sorry, the line producer refuses to put his name on the screen. Any man who used to work for Richard Nixon, and therefore we'll pay you $100,000, but we won't let your name appear on the screen credit. And I said, I'll take it and run, because it's such a rare thing to make any money at all in Hollywood. You're a conservative, and I want to take it whenever it's offered to me.
Ben, sometimes it gets even funny. I met recently with a producer, a really nice person, I won't use his name, who actually had nearly sold a show about a lawyer like me years ago, back in 2006, and then again, almost sold it again to Warner Brothers. And I said, well, now I think the time might even be better to have a show like that, because Hollywood's become very politicized. I mean, before they were kind of scared of political issues on both sides of the spectrum. And he says, Larry, do you mind if the main character is not a white male? I said, no, I don't mind. I said, what are you suggesting? He says, well, black females are very popular these days. So, you know, and he says, there's no room for white males in Hollywood these days. You know anything about that?
It's true.
I laughed, you know.
Yeah, but it's not a joke. Unfortunately, it's not a joke. I mean, you cannot turn on TV today without seeing lots and lots of black females playing leading roles, and more power to them. I mean, some of them are extremely fine performers and deserve to be on TV fully as much as anyone else. But the idea that there's now a racial test operating as a subtle form of racism is just sickening, and yet it happens all the time.
Well, I agree that everybody deserves to excel in their own merit, regardless of your skin color, race, color, or creed. But one of Ricky Gervais's so-called jokes, of course, they weren't really jokes. I mean, he was really driving the stake in the heart of the Washington elite, was that he was going to do a memoriam for all the people that died in the last year. But it just turned out that nearly all of those people were white. It wasn't a plurality. So he's going to wait till next year to make sure that there's enough minorities that died that he could actually do it.
I'm not sure if there are ever going to be enough of them. So that's going to be a problem.
Enough of that. Give us your take on what's been going on in Washington, D.C. these days over Iran, war powers, vilifying the president. Apparently, you know, he's come out on top with regard to Iran. He got them to back down for the moment. I'm sure they'll be back at it shortly in terms of killing Americans and killing others. But I want to get your take on it.
My take is that the Democrats have become the tools of the Iranians. And this is a shocking thing, that the Democrats have allowed themselves to become the tools of an actively terrorist power, namely Iran. And the idea that this has happened is just shocking and disgraceful.
Not only is it disgraceful on the Democrat side, but this week it was announced, leaked, by no doubt Williams and Connolly, the lawyers of the Clintons. I've been up against them for many years, as you know, particularly David Kendall. They represent the Washington Post. So this leak came out through the Washington Post that John Huber, who was appointed by former Attorney General Jeff Sessions, now is working under the authority of the new Attorney General, Bill Barr, who's been billed as a legal messiah, you know, by various people in the conservative media, that they weren't going to bring any charges against Hillary Clinton for corruption at the Clinton Foundation. I mean, no surprise. Of course, the Gang of Three, the Clintons, Bill, Hillary, and Chelsea, reaped millions off of that, you know, sold their offices for money pumped into the Clinton Foundation. But yet, no indictments under a Bill Barr Trump Justice Department, which tells us something.
I know. The Washington buddy system, you know, it's a law. It's an interesting thing. But the Washington buddy system has been working full tilt, even under President Trump, full tilt.
Yeah, and you know, and this is what I object to. This is why, you know, we do what we do at Freedom Watch. We bring citizens' grand juries. We're bringing out citizens' justice. You know, we are seeking indictments. We then try. We then sentence. Of course, we don't want to carry out sentences other than peacefully and legally, and we trust that the president will bring those sentences to four. We're going to be trying Robert Mueller sometime in the spring. We already had him indicted, and we will be seeking indictments again of the Clintons. I indicted her a number of years ago for breaching national security in Ocala, Florida, with a citizens' grand jury there. But the American people need to rise up. I mean, they have no Justice Department. It's unbelievable. And you're in government, Ben. I mean, you know, was it that bad in those days?
Yes, it was. Yes, it was. It was just as bad. And I can remember when I was a lawyer at the Federal Trade Commission, the basic attitude of the commission was, if they're big business, go after them, bang them up by their thumbs, torture them, do anything bad that you possibly can to them, and you're going to get away with it because they're Democrats and because your side is the Democrats, your side is the liberals, and so you can get away with anything.
I was also reported this week with regard to the Clintons that Chelsea Clinton reaped $9 million from getting a board position with a major corporation. Now, obviously, much like the half-wit Hunter Biden, former druggie, person who was just found this week by a court to be the father of a child that he had with a stripper, but he wouldn't admit it. He didn't own up to it. It had to be forced upon him with that kind of a finding, who is now rented. He's now rented a house in the Hollywood Hills for $10,000 a month, yet claims that he's destitute after taking, you know, billions from Ukrainian interests through the corporation he was working with. I mean, the whole place seems to be so out of control. It's Neverland. I mean, it's unbelievable, both in Washington and in Hollywood.
It is truly unbelievable. It's a two-state system. Basically, there's a state of Hollywood and the Washington power structure with which you can do anything you want and get away with it. And then there's a state of all the rest of us in which you do the slightest thing and the prosecutors are after you immediately. It's very, very much of a system whereby there's no justice except for the powerful. The powerful get all the justice they want.
Yeah, the ordinary people, they have to be killed at the stake, so to speak, but the elite walk off scot-free.
The ordinary people are just pawns in the game and have no rights, basically, except for whatever rights the beautiful people feel like giving them. And when I say beautiful people, I mean people like the network news officials and high officials of the of the Justice Department, high officials, anywhere. I mean, even under, as you say, even under Bill Barr's Justice Department, which is a very fine Justice Department, there's still going to be an enormous bias in favor of the rich and the powerful, and not just the rich and the powerful, but the beautiful people.
Yeah, they call Washington Hollywood for ugly people. They're flip sides of the same coin.
I never heard that. A very good one. It's a very good one. I love that.
So, Hollywood for ugly. where do you think all this is headed? I mean, I think we're headed. If the American people were more educated, I believe we'd be in a violent revolution right now, a la 1776. I mean, I pray that doesn't happen.
I don't think we're anywhere near that situation, but I think we're in a situation where we're having a quiet revolution in which the beautiful people are going to just little by little seize more and more of the power of the world and control more and more of the world. And it's a sad, sad situation because we did used to be a society in which there was some measure of justice, and we just don't have that anymore.
But unlike France in the days leading up to the French Revolution, which was very violent, which Thomas Jefferson actually was an architect of after he finished over here, do you think that these beautiful people like King Louis XV and Marie Antoinette, the equivalents in the United States now that reside on the banks of the Potomac, who think they're nobility, do you think, figuratively speaking, do you think they'll ever be taken to the guillotines?
Well, it's King Louis XVI, for one thing, but no, I don't think they'll be taken to the guillotine, but I think that people there are certain people in this society who will be put in prison and put in prison for long periods of time for no other crime, and that they're not part of the ruling faction. The ruling faction is what we used to call the Peter Jennings of the world, the people who run the world for the pleasure of themselves and their friends. And it's not a society in which we have anything like equality of justice for Americans of any size, shape, or form.
Well, of course, Jeffrey Epstein, this was another Ricky Gervais joke. You know, he was put in prison and he wound up dead. And Ricky Gervais referred to your friend, to the Hollywood elite core, Jeffrey Epstein. In any event, Ben, look, we've got a lot of work to do. We're going to try to change the way things are at Freedom Watch. We need the support of the American people, and we thank you for your support and friendship.
Well, and I thank you very much for working at it. I know you work very, very long hours, and you work very, very hard. You work on it with my dear friend Judah, and I know the two of you are going to come out with a great, 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 great series of video and TV events. They're going to blow the mind of the beautiful people and tell them that they cannot go around running roughshod over the ordinary citizen.
Well, thank you, Ben. Look forward to seeing you soon, my good friend. I know you're going away for the weekend, and have a great time.
God bless you, sir, and God bless America.
Before he was a trial lawyer, he sliced him and diced him.
People used to ask me, Larry, what caused you to start Judicial Watch and now Freedom Watch, given the powerful forces in this country that put you at risk?
In a meat packing plant.
I'm the son of meat packers in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I know how to slice and dice.
A very special prosecutor, Larry Klayman.
If you'd like to support Freedom Watch and this radio show, go to freedomwatchusa.org.
Fellow patriots, friends, Americans, people of faith of all stripes, we have to take stock right now. We just came through the Christmas period, the New Year period. It's time to reflect. It's time for New Year's resolutions. It's time to focus. It's time to see what it is that we need to do to save the country. The country is out of control. We have a president who did the right thing this week, who ordered a hit on the worst terrorist leader that was out there, now he's dead, fortunately, Soleimani, head of the Quds forces of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard. We have a lawsuit against the Iranian Revolutionary Guard in Iran with regard to the death of Special Ops Forces in Extortion 17. We had lawsuits with regard to Benghazi, but he did the right thing. And what happened? You had the Muslim congressman, Omar and Tlaib, and others vilifying him, claiming that somehow this was anti-American. Well, you know what their real motivation was, is that he killed someone who's a hero to both of them over there. And, you know, not all Muslims are bad people. I don't mean to suggest that, but these Muslims are bad people. And they have infested our government. And it's frightening that they have access to national security information and will go against the president. But it's not just these Muslims. It's plenty of others, particularly in the Democratic Party. It's even some in the Republican Party, whether it's Senator Mike Lee of Utah or Rand Paul. The president has the right to take out a terrorist. He did not declare war. There doesn't need to be any enforcement of the War Powers Resolution or amendment or whatever you want to call it. He has the right to protect the American people. He did not have time to call Nancy Pelosi, and he should have done it in any event because they would have leaked it, and our brave servicemen would have wound up probably getting killed, even though the hit came through a drone. Remember that Obama killed hundreds of people and never had to go to Congress. But layer that on top of what's going on with regard to our legal system in this country. I mean, all of a sudden they have this concern about international law and you can't kill people without declaring war. But yet at the same time, you have these criminals, people like the Clintons, people like James Comey, people like Rod Rosenstein, like Andrew McCabe, like John Brennan, like James Clapper, like Bruce Orr, like the whole lot of them, walk off scot-free, no repercussion. I mean, the president didn't send drones over their house, okay, but they're laughing all the way to the bank. Because that's what goes on in Washington, D.C. It's about power and money, and the American people can be damned. Just like King Louis XV and his corrupt queen, Marie Antoinette. After me, the flood. Après moi, le déluge. After me, I don't care what happens, because I'm going to rape and pillage this country. And that's what's happening in Washington, D.C. today, and that's why you need to support Freedom Watch. It's because we're not just getting documents like my former group does today. We're bringing hard-hitting cases. I take risks. I win cases, I lose cases. I'm not afraid to lose. If you're afraid to lose, you'll never win. And that's why we continue to bring lawsuits, whether it's regard to Trayvon Martin and a witness fraud, whether it's with regard to Laura Loomer or the social media companies trying to break them up so they'll compete and not discriminate against conservatives and others. We need your support. So go to freedomwatchusa.org. Support our cause. Join our Justice League. Share this radio show so the American people get educated, because they're not educated. They're not educated any more than the Hollywood elite. So maybe they come from different political spectra and ways of life, but the country's been dumbed down. You know, if you read the Federalist Papers or you read the writings of our founding fathers and see how learned they were and how they wrote. I mean, and they wrote in the way they wanted the citizenry to understand, because the citizenry could understand. They were educated. Today, my dog has a greater vocabulary, number of words, than most millennials do. Well, we need to educate people, and we need to rise up, and we need to save the country. And that's the revolution that we need to wage peacefully and legally, and we need your help to do it. So go to freedomwatchusa.org. Contribute to our cause financially and otherwise. Get our free newsletters. Contribute to CliveandBundyDefenseFund.org. They're trying to throw him back in prison, and that's the Trump Justice Department, if you can believe that. Or Jerry Corsi, who stood up there for you with a corrupt special counsel and said, I'm not going to lie in front of my creator and implicate the president in crimes. We need your help. So I want to thank you in this new year. God bless you. God bless your family. God bless America. And God save America. And I'll be back next week with another edition of Special Prosecutor with Larry Klingman.